Hello, we are very happy to join you at the Global Platform on Disaster Risk Reduction 2022 here in Bali, Indonesia. We are happy to share with you the progress we have been making on the African continent over the past few years, and more recently on the gain that we have made in multi-hazard early warning systems. The African continent recorded remarkable socio-economic development in recent years. Similarly, the continent has witnessed remarkable progress in disaster risk reduction. So many countries and economic communities, as well as the African Union Commission, have established institutions that are forward-looking. And this is an indication of a rapid, clear transition from reactive response to proactive management of disaster risk. In 2021, the African Union established the Africa Multi-Hazard Early Warning and Early Action Program. And this program has its pilot phase, which resulted to the establishment of three important situation rooms on the African continent. Here in Addis Ababa, we have the continental situation room for multi-hazard early warning systems. And in IGAD region, we also have one situation room that is what we refer to as disaster operation situation room, covering member state of IGAD region. Another situation room, which is more on climate advisory, established at ACMAT center in Niamey, is also functional. This situation room adapts a network approach, and this is something we'd like to see moving forward for the years to come to ensure that all our regions and member states are connected to one another. This program already, although it's in its final phase, is generating dividends and is contributing to attainment of substantial reduction in disaster losses on the continent. Whereas this remarkable achievement are commendable, the continent disaster risk has been on the rise, unfortunately. Yet, as the continent urbanizes and develops, more people and assets are being exposed to disaster risk. A more deeper analysis that was done recently by the African Union on the continent indicates that the continent risk profile is increasing, and this increasing trend is reflected in the rise in mortalities, economic losses, and people affected by disasters. In recent years, the continent witnessed some of the worst disasters in recent memory. In early 2019, Cyclone Idai, Cyclone Kenneth, had a combined devastating impact on Mozambique, Malawi, Zimbabwe, and Comoros, with over 1,000 people losing their lives. In mid-2020, flash floods triggered landslides in Cote d'Ivoire, affecting at least more than 1,000 households, translating to an estimated 8,000 people. In mid-2021 again, floods damaged an estimated 300 households and displaced about 40,000 people on the continent. In the first quarter of 2022 alone, four consecutive major cyclones, Cyclone Anna, Cyclone Batsirai, Demarco, and Imnati, hit Madagascar, with over 5,000 people affected and about 2,000 people being displaced. The list can be long. Many of these disastrous events occurred in part due to lack of effective early warning infrastructure, and also due to lack of early action. The current state of affairs in multi-hazard early warning system in African Union member states and regional economic communities is characterized by inadequate data for decision making and a non-network approach in information sharing, weak risk monitoring and forecasting capabilities, lack of timely access to risk and actionable information for decision making, and lack of coordination for anticipatory action and response. On many occasions, even when early warning information exists, early warning information had been disseminated sometime, even before disaster struck. But actually, we are either underestimated or too late. Other times, the uncoordinated nature of information exchange and overwhelming nature of the hazard resulted in significant disaster losses. There are also instances where authorities receive fire warning, but they could easily get overwhelmed with the response given the increasing nature of disaster risk. Unfortunately, these disasters caused by natural hazards are predicted to increase in frequency, magnitude, and they are likely going to become less predictable in the future. Further compounding the already volatile disaster risk context is COVID-19 pandemic. And indeed, COVID-19 has added more complexities and transformed our world. Africa bore the brunt of COVID-19 impact, as well as impact of climate change. Therefore, building resilience in an increasingly transformed world and Africa is urgent to support member states in preparing for, reducing the impact, and recovering from these disasters. In light of these protracted challenges, the African Union developed the Africa Multi-Hazard Early Warning and Early Action System Program. The program is a complex one, but it's also a multidimensional program that will change the game on the continent in terms of informing the African Union support to member states. And therefore, this will ensure that countries are prepared better and respond proactively and recover quickly when hit by disasters. And through this early warning system, we are adopting a multi-layered network approach to ensure that multi-hazard early warning systems, situation rooms, are communicating to one another across the continent. Achieving the goals of the program would require substantial international collaboration. Already, we have been collaborating with a number of multilateral and bilateral partners, and we wish to take this opportunity to pay our gratitude to our partners, the government of Italy, for financing the initial stage of the early warning program in Africa, and for the government of Sweden for supporting the development of the institutional framework that is vital for the long-term sustainability of the AMHEWAS program. We wish further to extend our gratitude to our technical partners, the United Nations Office for Disaster Risk Reduction, the Shima Research Foundation, and United Nations Development Program for supporting the initial stage of this program. To build on this milestone and go further on the African resilience journey, the African Union Commission is calling on its member states, regional economic communities, local authorities, and other stakeholders, including the academia, civil society, private sector, to join hands in mobilizing resources for the implementation of these programs that will ensure that we also work coherently to achieve the resilient Africa we want. Thank you so much.